All right, here we are, Urban Fire Xtra with my boy Bow Wow. So how you been, bro?
I'm good, man. You know, working. You know, same old, man. Just putting up numbers, trying to.
All right, I like that. So recently, you just been on a tour throughout Europe and the UK. How's it been for you, man?
It's been good, man. It's been like a wonderful experience, you know, really because I haven't been here in so long. And it's just crazy that, you know, I took a break. Not really took a break because I've been home working. I've been in the States working for the past 5 years, putting out movies. And, you know, I switched labels. So, of course, that took some time. But, you know, for me to come back out here and for me to still be doing the same thing that I was doing the last time I was here, it's an amazing feeling, man. I've been to places that I thought people probably didn't even know who the hell I was, but you know, that's just me just being humble and always just not knowing my power and my strength of who I am. And I think that that's cool. And but I was surprised, man. Every show's been sold out. It's been crazy everywhere we've been, so I can't complain.
All right, that's good to hear, because like, you've been in the game for, like Biggie says, been in the game for years. It made me an animal. What's the secret to your success?
My secret to my success is the proper coaching from my big homies, from Snoop, from JD, from Birdman, and that's really it. That's what's really been my ammo and my tool for me to still be here for so long doing what I'm doing. I've outlasted a lot of the OGs in the game, and that's crazy. You know, I feel like I'm serving two hip-hop life sentences right now, you know? So it's all good.
Hey, Chris. Hey, Chris. Hey, man. Hey, man. You know, it's been a long time since we hooked up, man, and did something real, you know? something for them ladies, you dig that? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You got the wrong one if you think I ain't going out. Used to be the only girl would think about. I got a couple girls on call, I'ma bring them out. Imagine City stripper, huh? So this what this all about? I'm in the club doing my two-step. I put about 8 broads already, I'm just getting my feet wet. But I ain't even knocking your style, cause I be here all day trying to count how many girls want that. Ooh, see you on the vlogs, what you doing and all that. But look, do you know you making yourself look bad? If dude got a problem, better tell him to fall back. I'm blowing real big in VIP, yeah, that loud pack. See, it's me and Chris in here, so you know it's real thick in here. Better get your girl, cause yeah, trying to see how many I can fit in my Lambo. I never go raw, stay strapped like Rambo.
Actually motivates you, because a lot of people, like, they come out, do their hits, sell their records, and then like they still haven't got that buzz and they want to give up. But with you, like, you're still carrying, like you said, it's like almost like your second sentence you're going through. Like, what's actually motivating to carry on?
What's motivating me to carry on is just, you know, you can never get enough, man. You know, there's certain things in life you just can't get enough of. Somebody will say, you know, and it's true, you can't get enough money. You can't, not when they print it up every day. They print paper every day. So you can never not make enough money. Enough is never enough. So, you know, just this taste of success, yeah, it's cool, but I want more success, though. So it's just kind of like, that's how I am right now. So a little just ain't enough to me. I want the whole pie.
Okay, so now you're moving on. Like, you've grown up, you changed your style and everything. What is, like, your goals right now? Like, where you're at? What you want to do, like, this year? What do you want to do in the next 5 years?
The next 5 years, just dominate movies, movies, rap, everything. This year is pretty much already mapped out the way I wanted it to go. I'm filming 2 new movies this year, going on tour with Snoop in Australia. So, you know, this year is all about the work ethic and getting people back seeing Bow doing what he does, you know, and letting them know, like, yo, I never left it. Just because I go shoot a movie for 3 months, like, you think I forgot how to rap or I forgot how to perform? Come on, man. Like, this is what I do. I'm a professional. So, you know, in that light, this year is based off the grind. This is the most busiest year I've had in the past. I can't even tell you, man. I was on my Twitter and one of my fans said my birthday is in 8 days. I've been working so hard. I'm so delusional. I forgot that February don't go to 30 or 31
28.
Or 28 or whatever, however many days it is. So I'm confused. I don't even know what time it is. So
right. So you've been on the road for a while and you've been throughout Europe. Like, with the European music scene, have you noticed any people out there, like from UK, taking up any people that you're listening to at the moment?
I wouldn't say that I'm listening to, but I definitely want to get familiar with, you know, more UK hip hop artists and R&B artists, and there's been a lot of great ones that come from the UK and make it.
Such as,
what's my man?
Craig
Y'all took the words right out of my mouth. My man Craig did it big. Aside from him, of course, you know, Young Money, Cash Money's own Jay Sean. He had a number one record over there in the States. And I'm sure Dan was big over here, too. And then, you know, my homie Chris Brown hooked up with Chipmunk and did some stuff. So, you know, I'm really looking forward to, you know, I love when I go places. I love learning about their culture and what they like, you know, and... you know, it can even be in a different language. I'm open to it.
So could we see collaborating any UK stars, perhaps?
Yeah, whoever the biggest rapper over here, I want to work with him. It's on. It's whatever. I'm with it.
Okay, I like that. Because now, back in the day, people didn't even want to collaborate, but now it seems that people are more open. Why do you think this is?
Because, I mean, it's just carrying on the legacy of hip-hop, working with each other, spreading love through different countries and crossing different barriers and breaking barriers, and I think that's what it's all about. It's a bloodline. You know, we all do it. It's different forms of hip-hop, different arts, and it's dope when you can combine a UK artist with an artist in the States. Why do you think we had the Olympics to see who's the best around the world? You know what I'm saying? I haven't heard a rapper say I'm the best around the world or I'm the greatest that's ever graced the world. So it's kind of like that's how I look at it. We dope in the States. We do what we do. But it's dope rappers in the UK. It's dope rappers in Japan. It's dope rappers in Brazil. They all over the world. You know what I mean?
I hear that. Also, what I wanted to know was, like, a lot of rappers stick to just one thing, just rapping. But then you're a bit different. You've gone on to doing the acting as well. What do you love about acting, and why did you go deep into it?
Because it's challenging. Main reason why, because it's challenging. It's different than rapping. You know, every movie is a different character you're playing. You might have to talk with an accent. You might have to shave your head. You might have to do something. You don't never know what you're getting yourself into when you act, but it's a challenge, and I love a challenge.
All right, that's good to hear. You said about accents. Can you do a British accent?
Maybe just a little bit, but...
I like that, kid, but that's real tight, yo. That's straight, but that's real good. That's my American accent, if you didn't clock that.
Oh, yeah, no, I heard that one, though. That was
odd.
The lottery. We won!
I gotta call somebody!
No! Nobody can know about this, all right?
We're the only ones that know about the ticket. What can go wrong?
I wanna have your baby.
I know your mama.
You've been in a lot of films. And such as sitcoms as well, such as like My Wife and Kids, Moesha. Yeah. Back in the day, all those sitcoms were on. Nowadays, it's all reality shows. What do you think about these reality shows out now?
I find it entertaining. I mean, you know, it's like you get wasted and you just watch one of like Ray J's show, or you watch Flavor of Love and you just laugh. Like, I love reality TV. What I do on Never in a Million Years, because I'm a movie star, but that's a whole another situation. But I do like watching them, though. But I would never make one.
All right. So once again, you've been in the game for years. You've had a lot of success. What's your definition of success?
My definition of success? Me. I'm a walking billboard myself. Just look at me. I made it. That's a success. Anytime you make it from whatever point you started out from and you climbed up more, that's success. So everybody can be successful. It all depends on how much you really want it. That's what success is to me.
I'm being honest, this is shouty, I don't want you no more. So leave the keys to the Benz before you hit the front door, cause you losing, and she choosing. And like Chris said, I'm chucking up the deuces, on to the next one. All I ask is keep it real.
What are you currently listening to, like three songs on your iPod or your iTunes? What are you listening to?
To tell you the truth, I don't own an iPod. And my iTunes is the Greenlight 1, G2, G3, and all my records. I swear to God, I'm not lying to you. I'm always on YouTube listening to old school R&B music like Curtis Mayfield, Al Green, Isley Brothers. It's the type of stuff I listen to. You know, them young whippersnappers, they might not know nothing about that, but that's what I listen to.
And then if you could have recorded one song that you didn't actually record but wish you did, what song would it have been?
If I could have recorded one song that wasn't mine or...
That wasn't yours.
I don't know. I guess that's why I stand alone. Because I guess those records just wasn't meant for me. I make my own type of music.
That's real good. I like that. All right, man. This is Urban Fire Xtra with my boy Bow Wow. Thanks for locking in.